Hello and welcome. As we get settled into our various instruments, of which we'll identify and talk a little bit about, and play some music from the traditions from which they come, I would just like to reinforce that four out of five of the musicians up here teach at Caldwell Community College in some capacity. Three out of five of us. Charlie, you still here to teach here from time to time? We'll see if we can convince him. But we do teach music here, and we're really happy to be in this area, and this community is great. Theater. We've just recently begun an intro to world music class that you can take as an elective. It's currently online right now. A lot of what you'll see today are songs from Haiti and Cuba and West Africa and Brazil, all of which I cover in this class. We go to Tibet and India, Native America, all sorts of places around the world. There's also jazz courses. We'll do a lot of improvisation today. We were saying today, well, I have no idea what this is going to sound like today. You know, we kind of let these songs take on their own forms and improvise quite a bit, which is very popular in the jazz style, and it's really rooted in a lot of the music that you'll see today. So you can take that from us here. Music appreciation, if you just like music, well, golly, this course has it all, right? Whichever direction that sort of leads. And it usually leads to soundtracks, movie music, right? I think everyone's familiar with Star Wars. But anyway, what we're playing today is far from Star Wars. We'll start with a Haitian song. This is in recognition and sort of an invitation for Papa Legba. And that's a character in their folklore who's the gatekeeper, right? Has anybody seen Ghostbusters time of year? That might be Legba talking. He's a bit of a prankster as well. He's normally pictured in their artwork as an old man wearing ragged clothes and usually bent over with his back. He's got a cane and he's got a backpack of some sorts. Now in Haiti it would have been a straw backpack for carrying straw and sugar cane and so forth. But within that backpack is the cosmos, or a door to the spiritual world. He was also seen as the highwayman. Slaves that were brought over to the Caribbean at the Atlantic slave trade in the Americas had no chance of going back to Africa, but they could still sing their songs and follow the stories that they sort of grew up with Papa Legba being one. So you'll hear me say Nu Grand Chemin, which is a combination of French and Yoruban, an African and French language. And that means the new highwayman. So that's kind of the gist of this song. It usually begins most Cuban and Haitian and Caribbean ceremonies, just recognizing, hey, if we're going to get anywhere, we got to talk to Papa Legba first, and he'll open the key to the magic. Thank you. publicly thank Jimmy Griffin, who also is on this campus on the regular and performing around the area. You can get out of hiking and hanging out at his house and recording and writing albums, which he just released. You can find out where, Jimmy, on Spotify or
all of the above.
Yeah, but I think he's got a suitcase of CDs, so you can catch him right afterwards. But he's joining us as a guest artist. Playing a flute-like instrument that he'll talk to you a little bit about from his home, Brazil, and then he's graced us with one of his songs from his country, so we've learned it just most recently. So I'll let Jimmy Griffin take it from here. Thanks.
All right. So I'm going to be playing a... Sorry.
Is this thing on?
They turned it up for my weak voice. I play drums.
So this next song, it's a song from Brazil, from the northeastern region. And there's an interesting mixture of rhythms because of all the cultures that came in. That was one of the first places that the Portuguese came and a lot of the European colonies, or colonizers, I guess. And there's a lot of indigenous folks that live there, and also the slave trade. That's where a lot of folks landed before going to other places or taken to other places in Brazil. So it has a very strong Afro culture, a very strong indigenous culture, and a very strong European culture. So this rhythm is one of those that came from that culmination of all those coming in. So the rhythm, you can trace it back to African rhythms with some native Brazilian, in this case, Amerindians, with some urban dancing. So these things came by, came together and became this rhythm that they call baião. And so baião is similar to the word in Spanish bailar, which means to dance. And we're going to play a little samplage or homage to. And the song that we're going to be playing is from the person who popularized the baião. So this was in the 1800s that the rhythm was developed. And this person that I'm talking about is called Luiz Gonzaga, who in the 40s brought it to the attention of not only the whole region of the northeast of Brazil, but all over the world by the 70s. So it's a very popular rhythm, and he made his career playing that, and he plays the accordion, and you can find all kinds of different instruments, Brazilian fiddle, accordion, and I brought you one here, which is, here they call it the fife, and in Brazil we call it the pífano, which is basically any type of tube that you can make holes and blow on it and make noise. So this one is made out of PVC, I made it at home, very crude instrument, but it's a fun instrument to play. So we're going to play the Assum Preto, which is by Luiz Gonzaga. It's a very sad song about a bird. To make him sing better, they had to make it blind, so it didn't have anything to do but to sing.
Thank you.
Sounds to me like that bird did just fine. All right, we're going to kind of stay in Brazil. Brazil and the Americas had a strong kinship, particularly between jazz, commerce as well. I mean, Brazil is one of the most economically productive countries in South America and really the Southern Hemisphere. When you talk about the melting pot of the world, right, I think of Brazil. So Americans were certainly down there involved in that, and jazz just sort of made its way down there. Went into some familiar tunes or styles like bossa nova. If you've ever ridden in an elevator or watched a movie that makes fun of riding in an elevator, you might have heard dun da 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 da. Right? So that's came from that generation. We're going to play the less well-known one, Black Orpheus. Now, there was a movie When there was an opera back in the 1600s, 1607, Claudio Monteverdi wrote about Orpheus and his descent into Hades to rescue his dear Eurydice from the pits of Hades, and makes a deal with Hades while he's down there and says, well, you can have her as long as you don't look back at her until you get to Earth. Him being part human, right, what does Orpheus do? Looks over his shoulder and she disappears, right? A tragic story. So they redid that in 1963, 64, something like that, in Brazil, and retold the story very similarly to the opera that originally did it, with music throughout, but instead of Italian music, they play Brazilian music within it. So this is the theme song from that movie. It also happens to be in the top five list, I think, of Barack Obama's mother made the list, but some great music came from it. So we're going to take our little twist on it. I'm going to probably put another rhythm under it. They play bass drums that are called surdos, and they'll have a bunch of people playing a drum about the size, and a bunch of people playing a drum this size, and a bunch of people playing snares and stuff and parades, but it's just me. So I'm going to keep a real simple rhythm, and everything needs a little more cowbell. So we'll put a little metal, that would be my right cymbal, and I'll let Charlie take it from here on the steel drums. He dabbles in the jazz genre on this instrument, but also a Caribbean instrument from Trinidad. It's like a descendant speech. I'll start playing music like stuff. Drilling you out. Thank you. cellist a little bit, just because I'm playing on this. These are called Doom Dudes, and they're from West Africa. Funny, these guys should walk in. We're learning Kakalambe right now, a harvest song from the Baga people of Guinea, where these drums come. The last great empire in West Africa before colonialism that Jimmy mentioned, where Western Europe came in, divided in all these borders, was the Mande people, Mandenke and Malenke. And they fought on horseback up in the Saharan Desert, pushed the Moors back, who were taking all of North Africa and even into Andalusia in Spain. I'll play the djembe in just a minute, which you're probably widely familiar with that instrument. The djembe foles, or master drummers, actually wear hats that have horse hair on it, and the rhythms are repeated like you're riding a horse. So we're going to do the rhythm called Sunu. Sunu is really lighthearted, high energy, and it's just a recreational dance, right? If people feel like getting together in the center of the village, and usually there's these big, open, grassy areas where people throw parties and get down. There's a third drum here called Dunumba, which is the name of the drum, the name of a dance, and it also means to party. So there's it's high energy music and a lot of fun behind it. Some of it is still very serious, but not this one. This one's lighthearted. So the gist of it is calling Sunu, the best dancer in the village, to come forward, right, and start dancing so we can get the party started. Now, I'm just going to start with this. When I learned this tradition, usually there's a high and a middle drum, and then there's another low drum. This is usually like a baby voice, right? And this is the mother's voice, and then the low drum's usually the grandfather. That's the one hanging out at home. So that's the sort of core unit of the family. The father drum is sometimes the djembe, and they're off doing their own sort of thing. They're usually working, so forth. So it sort of represents that. The song itself is similar to learning songs on this. You just need a low and a high. Songs, and that's where it starts, is, well, what's the song about, what's it for, what's the purpose of it, and then there's what's called sort of a timeline. I like to call it a groove. Dancing, you've got a bunch of djembes, whatever instruments are sort of around. So we're going to take the spirit of that and put over top of it another instrument from that tradition. Charlie plays timpani regularly with the Western Piedmont Symphony. So it's real similar to this. The early timpani actually were made out of animal skins as well. So it's a nice fit. I'll be playing the bala, B-A-L-A, or balafone, which is a xylophone, but just the bottom white keys. Maria Kent will be playing violin today, sometimes viola, sometimes electric violin.
Hopefully not throwing it on the floor.
Which is the true worldwide acoustic quartet twist, right? Bringing instruments from all sorts of tradition. I would say more of a European tradition, downright Appalachian tradition, right? We see it more in the northern regions. The guitar, I don't know, takes on many faces, which Justin Butler will play. He's also kind of running it through some effects to get a lower bass frequency on this. So here is Sunu, and if you do feel like dancing, feel free. May I we sing it, you sing it too. Cool? Yeah.
guess she's not coming. Alright, we're going to turn it down just a little bit and relax after that one. Again, we've been speaking about the Atlantic slave trade, and that's where a lot of this music came from, is West Africa into Central Africa. Made its way into the Caribbean and South America, especially, and eventually up in the United States, particularly through New Orleans. It took shape there in American spirituals, jazz, rock and roll, hip-hop. So if you're feeling the groove, it's because you felt it before. Well, we're going to go to Cuba now and play some of the music there. They've got a belief system very similar to what they do in Haiti. That's very akin to Greek mythology. So if you've ever seen Walt Disney's Hercules, right, you've seen something from Greek mythology. So this is a trio of some of those characters, I like to call them, from their folklore. The first one is Eshu, which Eshu could take on any sort of form. Anybody watch Loki, that new Marvel thing, right? He's kind of a trickster. And American Southwest, there's the trickster of the coyote. So Eshu can take on any form. Ceremony I went to, there was a little libation, some food and alcohol set outside the church door, right, for Eshu, because you never knew what Eshu was going to do. But you got to give respect to Eshu and say, hey, we're about to do something. Respect. Then we'll go into Oshun, which this is her instrument called Shekere in general, Achatse, Ashon, all sorts of different names for it. But she's the goddess of rain, the giver of gifts. She's sort of like Aphrodite from Greek mythology for all you Valentine's Day fans. So we'll sing for Oshun, maybe make it rain, right? It's getting kind of dry out there. And then we'll end with her mother, Ye Ma Ye. It's associated with a much bigger body of water, right? Anybody salt life in here? Right, Ye Ma Ye is the watcher over the ocean. So we'll do a trio or a medley of those songs. Suayo mama Kenya, Eshu dara Kenya wo. Suayo mama Kenya, Eshu dara, Eshu dara Kenya wo. Suayo mama Kenya, Eshu dara Kenya wo. Suayo mama Kenya, Eshudara, 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 Kenya. Yeah.
shu, cheke cheke nita o shu, ire were were.
I think we're just about out of time. Rather than go with the unrehearsed one, why don't we do Don't Worry, Be Happy. In these troubled times, we'll give you a real familiar melody you can take with you and whistle if you start feeling blue. This is by an American composer, Bobby McFerrin.
Play the
no regista. So we are a worldwide acoustic quartet. We'll be at the Western North Carolina Sculpture event on November the 13th. So look for the advertising there. And rumor has it, if you get there early, if you come with the design, you can pour some iron into the design and it'll harden and you get to take it home with you. So we're going to be playing some tunes for Ogun, the maker of metals and so forth, while we're there as well. So we're the Worldwide Acoustic Quartet. Thank you for having us. Thank you, Justin Butler, our bassist, guitarist extraordinaire, for setting this up for us in the Caldwell Community College and Technical Institute campus here in Hudson. Thanks for being here. Don't worry. Be happy. Yeah.